Good morning and welcome to Wednesday Woo. I'm a bit early this morning. I have an appointment at 11, so I am early for once. So I hope you are having an amazing week. There are lots of things happening around the world that can really keep us out of joy and happiness. And I know something that I have struggled with in the past is being happy in my own life while, you know, tragedies are happening around the world. There's kind of a guilt thing built in that you shouldn't be happy. But happiness and joy in the woo world are the vibrations that change reality for the better. So embracing happiness and joy can actually be healing, not just for you, but for the planet. That's the theme of my Wednesday Woo today. And it's a theme that resonates deeply, I think, with all of us, that the power of joy and happiness can be a source of healing for ourselves, for our family, for the people around us. So whether you're joining us from home or work today, I am really pleased that you're here and watching. I appreciate everyone who takes the time to watch. I hope you've got a favorite drink. So let's explore how you can transform joy and happiness to transform your life. So first of all, let's clarify what I mean by joy and happiness. They're often used interchangeably, and happiness is typically seen as a fleeting emotion, and it's often tied to external circumstances, though that's not how I see it. I don't know if you know, but I do have a podcast called Choosing Happy, and it's been a real fascination with me, probably because I haven't exactly been the happiest person around with a lot of the events that have happened in my life. And resilience doesn't really hit it for me. It was about really understanding that we're here. If you read any spiritual book, we're here to experience joy no matter what outside circumstances are. And that's really the learning, is having understanding that you have the power to be joyful, to create a reality filled with joy, irrespective of the outside circumstances. And that power gives you the ability to impact those around you and to help them experience the life and world that they want to experience. So for me, happiness isn't about it, you know, being triggered by external events, though it can be. But I think we, you know, my whole point of my podcast is that we can choose happiness in every moment. Joy is seen as a deeper, more enduring state, and it's something I've kind of embraced. And it's something that I recognize that I wasn't allowing myself to experience, that I had a fear of being joyful because it could be fleeting. And I had this guilt thing around, you know, there are other people who aren't joyful, so I'll join them at their level rather than elevating them to mine. And it's only recently that I'm really embracing the fact that it is about, if you are joyful, if you are happy, it's not about lowering your energy, but encouraging and helping others move to a joyful state, because that's more beneficial in so many ways, not just in a emotional and psychological and mental health level, it's also a physiological level as well. You know, research shows that cultivating joy can lead to improved mental and physical health, and it can be a powerful tool for healing. So how do we cultivate joy and happiness in our lives? So let's explore a few quick strategies. If we take a moment to look at the science behind joy, studies have shown that joy can lead to lower stress levels, and joy releases endorphins and oxytocin, which can reduce stress levels and promote relaxation. And we all know the benefits of being more relaxed and less stressed. It improves the immune function. A joyful mindset can enhance your immune response, making you more resilient to illness. And it builds better relationships. Joy fosters connection and empathy, strengthening your bonds with others. And as I say, if you are joyful and giving, you can build better relationships because you're encouraging those around you to join you at that higher level. These benefits highlight why prioritizing joy is essential for overall well-being. But how can we invite joy into our lives on a daily basis? One of the obvious ones is practice gratitude, practice appreciation. And I do that every day. I do it in the morning, but I also do it at night before I go to sleep, because I do believe that when you go to sleep, those hours that you're asleep, sort of the last few things that you focus on, you carry over into your unconscious. So at the end of the day, I write down a list of things that I'm grateful for, that I'm thankful for, that I appreciate. And it can be the same things each day, but I try to find at least 2 to 3 things each day that are different, so that the general things that I'm really appreciative for are having my dogs around me, having my home, living in nature, you know, living in a beautiful, beautiful spot. So really embracing the emotion of it. And I think that's the important part, because we can all mentally write down what we're grateful for. We can all mentally decide what we're appreciating, but it's sitting in that feeling of appreciation while you do it that makes the difference. And practicing that simple technique can shift your focus on what's lacking to what's abundant in your life. And I think that's really important as well. Engage in play is number 2. So finding things that you were playful as a child, what things would you do again, whether it's drawing or dancing or playing sport? I borrowed my son's old Wii so that I could do some of the dancing challenges, because I'm on my own. I wanted something that was a little bit interactive. So that's something that I'm going to be starting in August as a part of my 100 days to 100% happier challenge that I'm doing for myself. I'm also running that as a challenge. If you're interested, you can go to choosinghappy.co.uk and find out a bit more about that. But yeah, engaging in play and, you know, actually creating a challenge to show up every day and do something playful, something joyful for yourself, whether it's even building a jigsaw. But if it means getting outside or engaging in something that gets your body moving, that's another way of really cultivating joy in your life, getting that movement and changing that energy. Connecting with others. If you're isolated, and I think a lot of us are more isolated since 2020, really connecting with others, whether it's face-to-face, which is the best way to connect with others, but also just taking that time to give someone a call, to have a quick chat, even whether it's 5 or 10 minutes, but just connecting with others during the day as well makes a massive difference, so that you remember that you're not alone and that you do matter and that your friends matter and everyone, each one of us, you know, it's a human requirement to connect, if you like. Mindfulness and presence. I think I've talked about this one before, and I use Headspace, and I am promoting them, but I'm not an affiliate. It's just something I'm doing, their 365-day challenge. I'm not doing very well at that, but I am turning up every day and doing some of the techniques. And, you know, being mindful and being present in the moment can really help you appreciate the small things. I think one I've mentioned before, one of the things I do on my dog walks is get really mindful about the plants around me. And I count the different flowers, the wildflowers, especially this time of year, that I see. And I can get easily up to 50 different plants and flowers on my walks. And that keeps me present in the moment and appreciating the beauty of each and every one of them, even when we normally class them as weeds. When you look at the intricacies and how they've been created, it's quite a miracle, really. Acts of kindness. Engage in random acts of kindness. Helping others can create a ripple effect of joy, but also it creates joy for you as well. Doing something that, you know, if you think of someone and you think, you know, I know they really appreciate this, like, then do it. You know, take the plunge and send them something. And it, you don't even have to put your name on it. It's just a random thing. And, you know, surprising people with things that you know they love is a magical thing to do. Now let's talk about joy as a healing force. Many people have experienced how joy can help them navigate different times. So through emotional healing, joy and focusing on happiness and the things that can shift your mood can act as a buffer against negative emotions, help us cope with grief, anxiety, and depression. Because if you're focused on joy, if you're focused on, you know, doing those things for other people as well and really helping other people, then it's difficult to get stuck in anxiety and depression because your focus is somewhere else. So it can really help you emotionally. And again, with grief, you know, the survivor's guilt, if you like, the fact that you're left behind and feeling it can... You can often get to a state where you feel guilty about being joyful. You feel guilty about those happy moments because that person isn't there. But the way to reframe that is to think about, would they want you to live the rest of your life without enjoying life, without aliveness? Physical healing. There are stories of individuals who, despite serious illness, found strength and resilience through joy. And laughter is such a healer, and it can even aid in recovery by reducing pain and improving overall health. The whole way our physiology changes through laughter and joy can be healing in itself. So remember, it's okay to seek joy even in tough times. It doesn't diminish your struggles. Instead, it can coexist with them, providing a pathway to healing. So as I wrap up today's discussion, I encourage you to take a moment to reflect on what brings you joy. What small changes can you make to invite more happiness into your daily life? And how can you share that joy with others? Thank you for joining me today. If you found this live stream helpful, please like, share, and subscribe for more content on happiness and on woo. And you can also check out my Choosing Happy podcast at choosinghappypodcast.com, and let's spread the joy together. Until Friday, keep shining and embracing the power of joy in your life. Bye for now, and have an amazing rest of your week. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this week's episode. If you enjoyed it or think it would be valuable to others, please do share. And if you really enjoyed it, please leave me a review. It really helps the podcast. All of the links are in the show notes, and I look forward to seeing you next week on the Choosing Happy podcast.